No, I may be right, and I may be wrong.
But I can help you with that. I don't want to help you with that.
I'm getting so hot. Oh, my.
Well, that concludes another frivolous call. Thank you, Wilma. From Brooklyn on the People's Republic of Flatbush party line for your phone call. But once again, don't know why I have to keep reminding you people of this. This is a political talk show. No one is interested in your recipe for Hungarian goulash.
Did she say a pinch of basil and 2 teaspoons of sage, or was it a pinch of sage and 2 teaspoons of basil?
Yeah, you hung up too soon. I wanted to ask her if I could add parsley.
I stand corrected. Now, how about we get back to the phones and, I don't know, since this is a political talk show, maybe talk politics for a change.
With your audience? Good luck.
I'm not sure any of your callers can even spell the word politics.
Hey, don't you be making fun of my audience, especially not my callers. My audience is highly intelligent, and most of my callers are pillars of the community. Now, let's get back to the phones. Who's next, Wally?
One of those so-called pillars of the community, Zach from Hopewell, Virginia, on the Democrat line.
Oh, God. Hello, Zach. How you doing today?
What's up, man?
Hi, Zach. How are you?
I'm, like, totally awesome, dude. I went on your show's webpage, and I really dig your new producer, Ethan.
That's Heather Dimwit. We got a webpage?
Not that I know of.
She's got red hair and a smoking bod, dude.
Well, she does have lovely red hair and with auburn highlights and a nice figure, but...
Dude, can you, like, ask her if the drapes match the curtains?
How dare you? You demented little perv. You should be ashamed of yourself. So do the drapes match the cards?
Play your cards right, big man, and you may soon find out for yourself.
Oh, baby.
What about me?
What about you?
Awesome, dude. Can you, like, ask her if those things are real or if she's, like, smuggling in coconuts?
What is wrong with you? You really should be ashamed of yourself talking to a lady like that. You make me sick. So are those things real or are you smuggling in coconuts?
What do you think?
You seeing this?
Can I help?
I'm sorry, man. You're right. You're my moral compass. I appreciate you setting me straight. That's why I listen and call your show. You care and always listen to what I have to say.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Later, loser. Oh, don't put them away. Wow. What are you doing after the show?
Oh, we will get together, but only when I say the time is right. I'll give you the hottest night of your life. I'll use and abuse you, stick my nails in your back, make you bleed, and have you begging for more.
Not gonna lie to you, now I'm a little scared, confused, and more than a little turned on.
Hey, why don't you ever flirt with me?
Get real, Wally.
No, really, can you give me one good reason why you don't like me?
Sure. You're scrawny, creepy, clumsy. You drive an 86 station wagon with wood paneling.
I said one reason.
He did say one reason, not an itemized list.
How about this? Let's get back to the phones.
Yes, let's do that. Because I am compelled to not give up until...
Until you get your message across and change the political landscape?
No, that's not it.
Until your ratings are no longer the worst in history?
No, that's not it. I'm compelled to not give up until I finally get a caller to talk politics.
Good luck with all that.
That's my line. Who's next on the phone, Wally?
Well, we have Rock from Philadelphia, which I can't seem to see my paper. Oh, there it is now. Falling along. On the Republican line, we have a guy named Rock, and along with his manager, Nick from Philadelphia.
His manager?
Yeah, he claims to have been the heavyweight champion of the world in the late 70s to mid 80s.
That's ridiculous.
He wants to talk politics.
Oh boy, here we go. Okay, Rock from Philadelphia on the Republican line. What's on your mind today? Hello? Rock?
Hey, yo, is that you, Adrian? Did you stop and get my suit to cleaners yet?
Yo, man, stop yelling. Get a grip.
That's not Adrian, you lunkhead. You're talking to William Anthony, the radio guy.
Hey, who's that, Nick? I never heard of him.
He's some tomato on a talk show no one ever listens to.
I'm right here.
Then why are we talking to this tomato?
I can hear you guys. What'd he say?
Yeah, but I don't have a locker, do I, Nick? You took it from me after my fight with Spider Rico.
He's a tomato.
Yeah, and I made tomato soup out of him. You should have been there, Nick. And I need my locker back, Nick. I could really use a shower. Even Butkus won't come near me anymore.
All right, you two knuckleheads. Stop having a lover's quarrel on my show. Yo, man, stop doing that. It's very annoying, okay? Now, I must say, listening to you speak, it sounds like you've been around boxing gyms all your life, you know? I get the feeling they used your head as a speed bag, Rock. But you claim to have been the heavyweight champion of the world?
I was the champion of the world. I fought Apollo Creed on the Bicentennial and lost by decision. But I beat him in the rematch when I got off the canvas in slow motion.
Slow motion, Apollo Creed, I have no idea what you're talking about. I do know this. Muhammad Ali was heavyweight champion for most of the 70s, and Larry Holmes had held the title until the mid-80s. No mention of a Rock or Rocky in boxing annals as champion at that time. You sure you were even really a boxer? Hey, Wally, you looking up his record?
Yes, and there was no one named Rocky as champion in that era. There were, however, like a dozen boxers named Rocky at the time, which is last name.
Hey, what's your last name there, champ? We're looking up your boxing record. That's if you even have one.
My last name?
Yeah, you do have a last name, don't you?
Of course I do. I'm just having trouble remembering it. I know it begins with a B. I remember my last name is Bangladesh.
No, that's the name of a country. Yeah, that's name of country also.
Wait, you mean there are two countries named after me? I told you I was champ.
Hey, you delusional much? There were no countries named after you, and you certainly were never a heavyweight champion of the world.
What do you mean he wasn't champion? I trained him. I taught him how to eat a Volkswagen and defecate a Cadillac.
Hey. Not on my show. You're gonna quit that right now. What is wrong with you saying things like that? Again with the Spider Rico.
Spider Rico, were you a boxer or an exterminator?
Good one.
Hey, who said that? Is it you, Adrian? You pick up my soup from the cleaners yet? Adrian!
Hey, man, stop yelling. That's just a sexy new producer. And I must say, sounds to me like you and your manager are both out to lunch. Okay, you two nut jobs. You called to talk about something political. So, once again, Rock, what's on your mind?
I just want to get back to the community. I want to tell all children to stay in drugs and stay off school.
You do mean stay in school and stay off drugs, right?
Yeah, that too. Just doing my part to get President Ford reelected.
Now you blockhead Jimmy Carter's president.
Oh, good Lord. Don't you guys even remember Ronald Reagan? That's California, and he was also President of the United States throughout the 80s. While you were the so-called champ, Rock, one would think you'd remember that.
I was too busy defending my title against the top contenders like Hal Herman and Tiger Smedrick.
Tiger Smedrick, were you a boxer or a veterinarian?
Not such a good one.
Hey!
You're going good, so I ran to Clubber Lang.
Clubber who?
Boy, did he knock me silly.
He beats you like you stole something off his mother.
Yeah. I got beaten bad a few times. Never broke my nose, though. How's my face look, Nick?
It's beautiful, Rock.
All right, lunatics. We got to be moving on.
I just remembered Rock's name. It's Rocky Bolivia.
Yeah, that's the name of a country also.
See, I knew a country was named after me. Why does God give me such a hard time about it? Nick.
All right, that's enough of those two snap jaws. You know what? I think his real name is Rocky Baloney.
I think his name is Rocky Bullcrapola.
I think his name is Rocky Ballyhoo.
Okay, we'll be back right after this.
What? Mine wasn't funny?
No, it wasn't.
Here's another product from our I Can't Believe It's Not Viagra sponsor, the Low T-Bow. It's a thrill of a pill that boosts your testosterone, protein, and calcium, so you feel younger, get stronger, and even stand up straighter. Made by Johnson's for Johnson's.
All right, now a word from our sponsor, and everyone knows how much I love our sponsors. As much as I love you, girl. This portion of William Anthony's show is brought to you by Vito's Loan Service. Uh-oh, Vito in
Preach.
The house.
Preach it, brother.
Vito oh, yeah. in the house. Preach oh, yeah. Brother. Vito oh. in the house. Woo! Vito in. Vito's Loan Service is known for their easy payment plan. You pay or they break your legs. It's that easy. Vito's Loan Service is there when the banks say forget about it. Ask about their very reasonable 125% interest rates. Remember, at Vito's Loan Service, no credit, no problem. No collateral, no problem. No job, no problem. Miss a payment, there's a problem.
It's a big problem.
It's a big damn problem. Okay, so come see Vito today. It may be the best move you ever made, or maybe the last move you ever make. Okay, let's get back to the phones. Who's next, Wally?
On the socialist line, we have Jimmy from Trenton.
Oh, no.
And he wants to discuss the problems the Whig Party is having.
The Whig Party? Well, I think one of their problems is they disbanded in the 1850s. Welcome, Jimmy from Trenton. What's on your mind? All right, Snapjaw. You called to talk about the problems the Whig Party is having.
Aye.
Now, why don't you focus and stop being a schmuck?
Aye.
Okay. Now, will you tell me the problems the defunct Whig Party is having? And please stop telling us your full name.
Will do me, lad. My name is Jimmy Fitzsimmons, and the problem with the Whig Party is manifold.
Yeah, like they haven't existed in 160 years. Probably because he died 150 years ago.
They need to address the tackle the big problems facing the nation.
Such as?
Such as why I, Jimmy Fitzsimmons, can't get a decent corned beef and cabbage sandwich anywhere in the state of New Jersey, and why the price of Guinness has skyrocketed. And we must make St. Paddy's Day a national holiday. Also, the Whig Party needs to stop misspelling its own name. I propose they drop the H. I find it absurd to spell the Whig Party with an H, my lad.
Do you? Well, I find this phone call totally absurd. According to you, the big problems they need tackling are not wars, the economy, world hunger, or the fact that rogue countries like Iran and North Korea are pursuing a nuclear program. Oh, no. The major problems is that you and your friends may have to pay a little more to get smashed on Guinness. And the pressing problem of a party that hasn't existed since before the Civil War using an H in their name. That's the big issues that need tackling.
Aye, laddie. I'm glad you'd be agreeing with Jimmy Fitzsimmons on these issues.
Look, doofus, I don't agree with you on anything. Do you? Really? Well, let me let you in on something. I detest you. I despise every fiber of your being. I abhor your very existence.
Aye, that's a relief. For a second there, I thought you hated me. Now, getting back to the Whig Party. I may be wrong, and it may be right. And if I'm wrong, I'll eat the bark of a tree. And if I'm right...
right.
All right, that's enough of that nut job. I'd like to start a deport Jimmy back to Ireland campaign.
Irish? I thought he was Scottish.
Scottish? I thought he was Puerto Rican. What's so funny? I was serious.
Oh, okay, my bad.
Take you down, let